Hey, once again, it's Daniel. How are you guys? Well, today's lesson that I want to go over with and talk about is emotion over intellect. You have to realize that there's more than three emotions. Most of the time, what we feel is we feel bored, we feel angry, or we feel happy. But like, look behind me, look at all these different compartments, all these different caves. That's how your brain is and your heart, the way they connect. There's joy, there's compassion, there's sadness, there's all kinds of emotions, as you can see behind me. It's not always just going to be angry, bored, or sad, you know? There's a lot more to it. The way I would describe emotion over intellect, it's like when you're sober and you're not on drugs or when you're not angry, you can think clearly. You can like say, hey, there's a camera there. I'm not going to get in a fight. I'll get in trouble. You can say, I'm not going to say these bad words right now because I know later on when I need those shoes, my mom's not going to buy them. But when we're emotional, we end up using our emotions instead of our intellect. And like when you're incarcerated, once again, a lot of times when I was in there and I would talk to people, and I know me for myself, I'd be all clean and sober and steady and calm, and I always spoke good and was respectful to people. And because I was sober, I would always make good decisions and I would eventually get out. But then once I'd get out, I'd start getting angry again because I didn't get my way or something, and I'd start being mean to my mom, my family, my girlfriend, and end up killing it, you know, for myself. And because I was angry, then I would go and get drunk because, you know what, forget it then. I don't like the way I feel, so I'm going to get drunk. I didn't realize that I had it in me to get a natural high. That if I was angry, I could walk around or go for a run and change it. I didn't realize that if I was sad, that I could watch a movie, a funny movie maybe, and laugh. A lot of times we don't realize that we function on emotion over intellect.
Like you see athletes use frustration and anger to go out there in the field and play harder. You see people like, there's some parents like dads that work hard and moms that work hard because they want to provide for their kids. And they actually have to feel a little angry that they didn't go to high school and college and they have to work 12 hours instead of 8 hours. So they use anger as that energy. But I want to give you another example. Okay? Anger is always going to be a secondary emotion. And anger is a very good energetic emotion. So be careful how you use it. And as an adult, we have to be careful and not tell people things about their anger. Like, you're an angry person, you're an angry person. Because then what ends up happening is like, all right, I'll clean my room and use a lot of cuss words, and they're all angry and they have all this energy and clean their room. But the problem with that is they get used to only completing a task when they're angry. And we don't need anger to be successful. But what my point is today is that anger has a lot of energy. And if it's harnessed, it can be used.
Over intellect. Intellect is just thinking clearly and doing things that aren't going to have consequences later. But doing things emotionally, we do it out of anger, or out of sadness, or out of I'm going to pay you back. And a lot of times when we're under the influence of drugs and alcohol, again, it's emotion over intellect. Like I said earlier, there's a camera there. You're sober. You're like, I'm not going to do nothing. There's a camera there. But when you're drunk, what happens? You do stuff, and later on, people show you on camera. They film you, or you get in trouble, and you get arrested. And they're like, yeah, we have video footage. And you're like, ugh. So, always remember, you have more than three emotions.
So,
you
actually
always
have
remember, you have more than three emotions. You actually have 22. Use them. Understand them. Exercise them. Because if you don't exercise your emotions and learn them, it's like a muscle. It's just never going to work. You need to exercise your emotional muscles to have strong emotions.